like a Tim.
They want to review every account, every bank account above a $600 balance or with more than $600 of transactions in a year. I think I'm just over that $600 balance and transaction level. So basically, every American with a job is going to have IRS scrutiny under this proposal. And maybe, you know, like your own IRS agent that you can lean on to maybe cash a check, write a check. Make a deposit when you're not available.
But that's none of their business.
I love it. I think that's great. Tightening the relationship between the IRS agent and the individual citizen. I think that's going to be very good. But I don't know how that will set with our next guest here, Steve Leahy, because will he be out of a job if the IRS is going to provide that sort of personal service to individual Americans? Steve Leahy, tax attorney with Opum Tax Advocates. He's also host of the IRS Radio Hour on these airwaves, AM 560, Sundays at 5 p.m. Opum, Amy, is Latin for hope.
Hope.
That's correct.
Right.
Very good. Well done.
So, right. You know, I would say this will help me, obviously, right? They get more IRS agents. That's good for me. But I've been up in arms about this whole thing about the bank statements and everything. Another provision is they're going to also go after the records of PayPal and Venmo. If you
Zelle and all
those.
Yeah, right.
Right now it's at you have to do $20,000 or more or 200 transactions before they have to reveal that information. And now that's going to $600 too. So,
well, when did you learn about this?
This has been going on since May. I've been screaming from the rooftop since May about this.
I'm just catching on.
Well, they just started talking about it last couple of days, maybe last week, maybe.
Well, won't this be good though? So, you know, in case I'm not, making my quarterly payments, or I'm, not prepared for the tax bill I may get come around, April 15. You know, in terms of what I'll be forced to pay. I've got this IRS agent right there next to me. They're on my account. They can help me budget for my tax liabilities and make sure I'm filing everything on time. And so I don't get into trouble. And then I got to hire you to talk to the IRS agent, take them to the Cubs game and, you know, make it all good.
Well, you know, they talk about they're only going to tax people over $400,000. But it's just not true. The three things that they're really harping about, you've been hearing this since Joe Biden came in. The one is you keep hearing about a tax gap. You know, the tax gap is the difference between what the IRS collects and what they think they should collect. It's been about $300 billion, for many years, about 15%. All of a sudden, they're telling us it's $1 trillion. And that's why they tell you that that this whole fiasco won't cost anything. It's free because all they're going to do is go after people who aren't paying their taxes, and that will pay for everything. And it's like the fraud and waste that we always hear about every election. You know, if we just get rid of a fraud and waste, you know, everything will take care of itself.
You know, this also with respect to this proposal, I understand that leaking confidential IRS tax records is a crime. I understand a crime was committed when that happened to Bezos and Bloomberg and Trump. And so now you'd have that many more people with access to your private financial records and that much more opportunity for leaking and other other illegalities. I suppose the good news is those illegalities are not prosecuted if the target is the right target. So then maybe they wouldn't have.
Well, we've had this before with the IRS targeting conservative organizations.
Yeah.
And all of that.
And remember what happened to Lois Lerner. She went to prison for.
Oh, that's right.
Oh,
she got retired.
No. Yeah.
She retired on a nice pension.
Yeah, that's right.
That's right. They never went after her.
Yeah.
And they never would. You know, and all of this, I don't know. This goes back to me, it's a violation of our Fourth Amendment for them to take our bank records. Some years ago, the Supreme Court said that if a third party has your records, it's not protected. That's been kind of and in response, Congress did the Right to Financial Privacy Act. And so that's the law right now. It's the government cannot go at prohibited, the law says, from getting any of your tax information. I mean, your bank information.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this whole bill has got to rewrite this, your privacy. And that's really what I'm really up in arms about, this giving up our privacy. Also, there's a provision of the bill that's going to start testing about mileage taxes, right? And so because they need the money for the roads, so they want to put the
tolls aren't enough.
They want to put the GPS in everybody's car, so they could now. What kind of privacy is that? They're gonna know exactly where you go, where how long you stay there. You know, all of that information is going to be available. And as you point out,
We got to know your carbon footprint.
Yeah.
Well, that's what they allege, and then they'll use it for other things.
Well, yeah.
Like, look at Ancestry.com. It started out, we'll help you find your, you know, your lineage. And next thing you know, they're arresting people because their DNA matches something from a crime scene.
Exactly. And that's what's more private than your DNA. You know, it's public. You know, we're going to just make everything public.
My Dungeons & Dragons collection is more private.
That's what they're after.
Give us, again, the business that you do as a tax attorney and dealing with the IRS on behalf of your clients. Give us, your value add.
Generally, what I do is I help people who owe the IRS money, usually small business people, right? Mm-hmm. So if you're a W-2 employee, right, the IRS is after your, they got your money. They have a 95% compliance rate with people who work as a W-2 employee. So that's the tax gap that I was talking about. That's who they're targeting. And who is that? That's small business people that the IRS doesn't know what you make because they don't know who your customers are. That's not reported. And this was some years ago that required businesses to report any payments that you made over $600 to anybody. This was some years ago. So they've been targeting this for a long time, and that's where they kind of couch this in the terms of fairness. It's not fair that if you're a W-2 employee, you have to pay your tax, that they get to take it. But if you run your own business, they can't just take it, and they don't know what you make.
Everything is about getting the elusive wealthy tax dodger,
exactly.
Right? Yeah.
And the wealthy tax dodgers are people who run their own business. Of course, that's just not... It's not true.
Right.
Now, a lot of folks are still experiencing IRS delays and problems with refunds and the child tax credits. How are you helping them? Because I know it's...
Here's the thing. It's really hard. It's hard to get the IRS on...
You can't get them on the phone.
They were bad before, but now it's at like 10% that they're answering 10% of all phone calls. So you can't get them on the phone. Mm-hmm. And for someone like myself, if I try to send in my power of attorney, once someone hires me, I get a power of attorney. I send it to the IRS. Once the IRS has that, then they can share information with me.
Right.
But I can't get it processed. They won't. So I'm in.
How long have you been? Like how long? Normal.
A year. You know.
Oh my gosh.
It usually takes 2 weeks. So I've been sending out Freedom of Information Act requests for my clients, trying to get some of this information. And of course, there's a lot of pushback. They have a lot more duties now. The child tax credit, the stimulus checks, the unemployment tax that they tax people on and trying to give the refund.
Yeah.
So they put that priority. Many people, their 2020 tax returns are still not processed.
Sure.
Well, they're not 2019 taxes are not processed.
And they use it because of COVID.
Yeah, it's COVID. Well, they're all home.
Well, and then you have like former Obama administration Treasury secretaries who don't know how to use TurboTax, and then the IRS agent has to do Tim Geithner's taxes over for him, stuff like that. Now, what if I wanted to, just like Al Sharpton, just like take a decade off from filing taxes? And then, get back around to it sort of when I feel like it, and then we'll work something out. Then I hire you, and you just say, Dan just was a bit, procrastinated a bit for, the 21, the 2020s.
Procrastination is what is my client. That describes my client.
Yeah, right? 2020. So I'm from this time to like 2030, I just don't feel like it. I'll get around to it. And then I hire you and you just make it all go away.
Well, I wish that were true. And sometimes you can, because here's the thing with all government kind of programs. If you don't have anything, man, there's lots of programs to help you. If you have things, there's no program for you.
Right. Oh, there's a program for you, but it's going in the other direction.
Exactly. So so you try to make it to in some sort of methodical way to pay it. Rather than because they want everything yesterday, and they have the power to take it from you.
And the conventional wisdom, as a practitioner, tells us it's true. Like, they obviously want their money, but if if you're in arrears, but you act in good faith, you can you try to work something out. I mean, they don't want to go to court. They just want to get you on some sort of plan to pay what you owe, right?
Well, so I'd say sometimes that's true and sometimes it's not. Again,
okay.
Because sometimes if you have something, the revenue officer, again, their duty is to collect money from you, right? And the IRS has very stringent rules about how much what your budget should be. So they look at your income, and then they have this fictional budget that says, well, this is what you should pay, and this is what. So we look at your income, and of course they know what your income is.
Oh, right. Right. Well, right.
You, yeah. You know, that you report it.
Yeah.
And then, so then they say, well, here's what your budget should be. And then they deduct that from your income and say, well, this is what you can pay. And this is where the problem comes in, because that number is much higher than you think that you actually can pay. And that's where the,
so like the budget,
that's where the fight comes in.
So if you blow your budget like on Beanie Babies or something, then they look at that and they say, well, that's...
Aren't those valuable?
They're valuable to Ty Warner. I don't know about it. I don't know about me. But that's interesting that's how they do it. They kind of look at it and say, here's what you should have been doing. And if you're outside of those parameters, then you're flagged.
That's right. And then again, if you have something, if you have some property, they'll take it away from you. Or they'll make
lien
you sell it.
Yeah.
Well, there's always a lien.
Yeah.
They're going to get a lien. And here's what people don't understand is, even if they don't file a lien against you, if you owe the IRS money, they already have a lien against you.
Yeah, right.
So they don't have to file anything against
you. What about taking of your passports?
That's a $50,000. If you owe more than $50,000, that's another thing. That just happened.
They come to your house and take, how do they?
They
come
just cancel it. So if you try
to
renew it, so I get this a lot, and they've been very aggressive on this. This is last couple of years. I think 3 or 4 years ago, they implemented this program to take away your passport. I call it the Chicagoization of the federal government.
So they just cancel it, or if you try to get
like
on a plane.
Like the state of Illinois does, right? If you owe the state of Illinois, and I always tell people, the Illinois Department of Revenue is much more aggressive than the IRS is.
Yeah.
It's harder to work with the Illinois Department of Revenue than it is the federal government.
So in Illinois, what's the penalty if you owe what?
Oh, well, here's the thing. If you owe them money, they could take away your license. And
and
as we know, every occupation has to have a license.
Right.
You know, so in Illinois.
So
they take it away from you.
The matter of auditing, like if you're late a couple times but you pay penalties and you pay up and you get square, if you're like that, does that is that more likely to trigger you getting audited at some point?
Well, once you're audited, it's more likely that you're going to be audited again, right?
Okay.
Because they almost always find something wrong, and again, these are usually business people that are taking deductions, and those deductions they take every year. And so if they don't allow them with an audit from 3 years ago, then they look at you this year and say, well, you know, you took those same deductions and they weren't allowed then. And this is why the first thing you should do is structure your business correctly so you don't put the red flags in. So most small businesses, sole proprietors, partnerships, what they call the LLCs, these are what they call flow through. But they also put that on their personal tax return. So the first thing you want to do is get your business off of your personal tax return and put it on a separate entity tax return.
And so like the deductions, the nature and the number, right? So don't run your accounts like Jesse Jackson Jr. ran his campaign fund, where, you know, buying like souvenir Michael Jackson gloves is a business expense and that sort of thing.
Exactly. And again, I've seen a lot of people get audited again when it's on their personal tax return, and many of these are legitimate deductions that aren't allowed because they're on your personal tax return. And that's another reason why you want to get it off of there, get your business expenses on a separate tax return. And that's about structuring your business. Who pays the most taxes in our society? Small business people,
right?
Because they don't structure their business correctly, and they think, well, you know, I'm not big enough to really make a difference. But that's just not true.
Well, how can people reach you if they're a small business owner hearing right now?
First, go to chicagotaxteam.com, and you can find me there. But or you can call me at 312-664-6649.
All right. He is Steve Leahy. He's a tax attorney with Opum Tax Advocates. He's the host of the IRS Radio Hour, where you get more insights like he was just giving. That's 5 p.m. Sundays on these airwaves, AM 560, and chicagotaxteam.com.
Correct.
Is where you go. Steve Leahy, thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
This is The Morning Show. More Chicago radio listeners are choosing. This is Chicago's Morning Answer on AM 560, The Answer.
Remember the kids' game Telephone?